Nearly 10 years ago, the Bears and the Browns squared off before a Monday night audience. Unlike this evening's game, which could shape up as a defensive duel, their 1980 matchup saw points of plenty coming from both sides. Our latest Monday Night Memories installment recalls the glory days of Sam Rutigliano's Cardiac Kids of Cleveland, who proved to be too much for the still-rebuilding Bears.
Election Day Eve 1980 marked the calm before the storm of a new administration in Washington. But in Cleveland, over 83,000 thundering fans were on hand to see the Browns' defense blow away one of the game's greats. Chicago's offensive commander-in-chief, Walter Payton, never could seem to break through the Browns' armed forces. The Crunch Bunch would have won any popular vote in Cleveland this Monday night as they held Payton to a season-low 30 yards rushing and held the Bears to two first-half first downs. Bunch also made life miserable for quarterback Vince Evans, who completed just three passes before intermission. And while Evans and the Bears were trying to find a way to break the bunch and quiet the massive Cleveland crowd, Browns signal caller Brian Seif was showing why he was selected as the league's most valuable player in 1980. Seif kept the Bears' secondary busy all night as he threw for nearly 300 yards. A good deal of that total going to third-year tight end Ozzie Newsome. Reggie Rucker scored a second-quarter TD to give Cleveland a 10-0 lead. And it looked like this game might be a bigger blowout than the Reagan-Carter matchup the next day. But Bears coach and great communicator Neil Armstrong had some words of wisdom for his quarterback. And it was evident from Evans' second-half performance that Armstrong's message came through loud and clear. Evans rallied the Bears in the second half and made the Browns' hearts skip a beat as their lead shrunk to 20-14 in the fourth quarter. But Brown running back Greg Pruitt made sure the Bears' comeback march would falter. He scored twice in the final stanza, including this 56-yard run in the closing minutes to pace a 27-21 win. Pruitt's season-high 129-yard effort kept a path burning brightly that would give Cleveland its first division title in 9 years and give Sam Rutigliano his second straight AFC Coach of the Year award.